Dear viewers, how are you? Today I shall teach you the last portion, the last section of Leo Tolstoy's parable, Three Questions. In my two previous classes on Three Questions, I told you that the theme of the parable is wisdom, forgiveness, acceptance, clemency, and blah blah blah. This is the message of the story. Today, I shall start with the page number 88 from this line. Here comes someone running, said the hermit. Let us see who he is. When the Tsar pressed the hermit for answering his three questions, the hermit told him that someone is coming. The Tsar turned round and saw a bearded man coming running out of the wood. The man held his hands pressed against his throat. The blood was flowing from him. The blood was gushing out from his stomach or belly. When he reached the Tsar, he fell fainting on the ground, moaning feebly. He swooned on the ground. The Tsar and the hermit unfastened the man's clothing, untied his clothes of the wounded man. There was a large wound in the stomach, and they found that there was a large wound in his stomach. The Tsar washed as best as he could and bandaged it with his handkerchief. He used his handkerchief to bandage the wound, and with a towel the hermit had a towel, so he also took the help of the towel to bandage the wound of the man, the unknown person coming from the direction of the jungle. But the blood would not stop flowing. It was a deep, as a result of which blood was coming out rapidly. And the Tsar again and again removed the bandage soaked in the warm blood and washed them and rebandaged them. At that time there was medicine or drug, so they tried to soak the bandage, and after he dried and again soaking it in the wound. When at last the blood ceased flowing, at last the blood stopped flowing, the man received and asked for something to drink. He got his consciousness. The Tsar brought fresh water and gave it to him. All these things that the Tsar began to nurse the wounded man. So through these activities will actually give him his answers. The questions he raised, the answer will be given by the activities adopted by the was served by the Tsar himself. Meanwhile, the Tsar had saved and it had become cool. So the Tsar, with the hermit's help, carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him in the bed. Lying on the bed, the man closed his eyes and was quiet. He was very weak because the amount of blood gushed out from his body. But the Tsar was so tired with his walk and with the work he had done that he crouched upon on the threshold and also fell asleep so soundly that he slept all through the short summer night. So it was a summer season, only April. And the Tsar was very tired, so he also fell in a very short time. And how no time to ask him what had happened to the wounded man. When he awoke in the morning, it was long before he could remember where he was or who was the strange bearded man lying on the bed and gazing intently at him with shining eyes. So when the Tsar awoke, he was rather surprised, because it was not a kingly bed. it was on accessorated. He could not determine what had happened in his what had happened in the previous night. He only saw the bearded man staring at him. "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice. "Forgive me." When he saw the Tsar was awake and was looking at him, "I do not know you and have nothing to forgive you for," said the Tsar. The Tsar declared that he did not know him. So why should he forgive you? Or what is the necessity of forgiving? Necessity for forgiving you. If there is no familiarity, if there is no familiarity between them. So what the question is irrelevant. "You do not know me, but I know you," the wounded man said. "I am that enemy of yours, and who sought to revenge himself on him because he executed his brother and seized his property." The wounded man said that he came there to kill the Tsar because it was the Tsar who executed his brother and seized his property. "I knew you had gone alone to see the hermit and resolved to kill you on your way back. But the day passed and you did not return." He was waiting. The man was, the unknown man or the enemy of the Tsar was waiting outside, or hiding outside. Whenever the Tsar would come out from the hermit, he would bounce upon him and kill him. "So I came out from my ambush to find you. When he found that the Tsar did not come out from the forest, and you know what had happened to the Tsar, and I came upon your bodyguard. But suddenly the Tsar's bodyguard appointed outside the area of the hermit came to know the wounded man and they pounced upon him and wounded him. I escaped from them but should have bled to death had he not dressed my wound. But he would have died. If the Tsar did not help him to medicate him with or bandaged him again and again. I wish to kill you and you have saved my life." So there is an opposition of thoughts. The man wanted to kill the Tsar, but the Tsar, who was quite totally ignorant of this thing, wanted to save the life of his enemy. "Now if I leave and if you wish it, I will serve you as your most faithful slave and will bid my sons do the same. Forgive me." So he promised to serve the Tsar throughout his life, and even his son would also a place to be the slave to the Tsar in future, because it was the Tsar who helped him to revive. The Tsar was very glad to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have gained him for a friend, and he not only forgave him but said he would send his servants and his own physician to attend him and promised to restore his property. It's a grand opportunity for the Tsar to resolve the crisis or the resolve the enmity without making any war. So the Tsar also shows his goodness of heart, telling him that insane physicians to treat him better, to attend him, and promised to restore all his property confiscated earlier for the fault unknown to us. Having taken leave of the wounded man, the Tsar went out into his court, means veranda, and looked around for the hermit. Now it was the Tsar's time to go out, to return, but he needed to have the answer. He needed to have the answer. Before going away, he wished once more to beg an answer to the questions he put. Yet too, the hermit was outside on his knees, wearing seats in the beds that had been dug the day before. The hermit was swaying the seats. The hermit, you see that the hermit was always involved in creative activities, digging soils and then swaying seeds. So he is involved in creative activities. Everything is positive about the hermit. You have already been answered, said the hermit, still crouching on his legs and looking at the Tsar who stood before. But you have already, the hermit told the Tsar that he had already been answered. And the Tsar was taken aback. He was surprised how the answers were given, because there was no formal answers from the hermit. No formal answers. So he was surprised. What do you mean, asked the Tsar? Do you not see, replied the hermit. Now the hermit illustrated the whole incidents or the events through which his problems, his questions are spontaneously answered. Spontaneously answered. It is the situation which have answered his questions. If you need not pity my weakness yesterday, see one thing. If the Tsar did not pity the weakness of the hermit yesterday and had not dug those beds for him, but had gone or returned to his palace, that man would have attacked him. The enemy who ambushed might have attacked the Tsar, and he would have repented of not having stayed with him. Then you repented or regretted for not staying with the Tsar. So the most important time was when you were digging the beds. The most important time is when the Tsar was digging the beds. And I was the most important man. And the Tsar told him that he was, at that time, was the most important man. And doing good was your most important business. So three answers come out spontaneously from this situation. Afterwards, when that man ran to us, the unknown man who happened to be the foe or the enemy of the Tsar, the most important time was when you were attending to him. At that time, the most important time was when the Tsar attended or nursed him. But if you had not bound up his wounds, he would have died without being made peaceful. If he did not nurse him well, the man would have died without making peace with him. So he was the most important man at that time. And what you did for him was your most important business. Again, there are three answers. All the answers depend on the situations. There is no stereotype answers. The normality lies in that. Remember then, there is only one time that is important now. the most important time in our life is now, that is the present time, because it is the present on which we can, or the present which, the time which we can control, we can regulate, we can mold, we can make use. It is the most important time, because it is the only time when we have any power. The most necessary man is he with whom you are. Now, Tazar, you made a controversial comment that the most necessary man is he with whom you are. It may not be true in all cases, because if an infected man is beside me, he is not the important man. Or if an antisocial is beside or behind me, or is at a close proximity to me, he is not the most important man. Because it is the only time when you have any power. No man knows whether he will ever have dealings with anyone else. And the most important affair is to do him good. Because for that purpose alone, man was sent into this life. This line is almost biblical, because God has sent us all to serve others. Jive prem kare jeijon sei jon sevichishon. So we are sent here by God to serve people, and to serve people means to serve God. This is the message. This line is very important. So this, it is the end of the parable. Thank you for very much for being with me and listening to me carefully. But before finishing my lesson, I will show you some important words and vocabularies which will be helpful for proper understanding of the story. A bit, idiom means a little. Turned round means moved the other way down, out of, from, inside of. Pressed, held firmly, chepeta. Flowing means gushing. Fainting, falling unconscious. Achitamava, again with. Unfashioned, untied, moaning, making faint sound. Soaked, wet with, bhijeda. Repented, regretted, dealings, interactions, seized, stopped, received, became revived, became conscious, gushing, gazing, staring, revenge, vengeance, show, vote, seized, confiscated, bajayatapara, assumed, shakota, executed, kill, kumpara, resolved, decided, ambush, look at a hideout, slave, bonded labor, das, enemy, shatru, foe, opposite God is friend, promised, pledged, prathisukura, crouching, sitting with knees, atumura vasha, porch means baranda, restore, give back, feed it. So this is all about the story. Three questions, which is taken from the collection of stories, when men live by, and other tales written by Leo Tolstoy. So, thank you for being with me, and I again request you to follow the classes regularly, so that it will give you benefit for the HS examination to be held in the next year. Maintain the lockdown, stay at home, stay safe, and study.